Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to the School of Engineering's presentation for UConn Bound. My name is Dan Burkey, and I'm the Associate Dean for Undergraduate Education and Diversity in the School of Engineering. I'm also a faculty member in the Chemical and Biomolecular Engineering Department. If at any point after this presentation you'd like to contact me, please do so at the email address provided here, or visit us at undergrad.engr.ucon.edu. So many of you may be considering multiple schools at this time, and so I hope to provide you some reasons why we think UConn Engineering is the place to be. Out of almost 600 public institutions in the United States, UConn is consistently ranked in the top 25. We have some of the best faculty and programs in the nation. Also out of that 600 public institutions, we're number 21 in the national metric of six-year graduation rate, which is much higher than typical publics. This is a testament to our academic and other support programs across the university. Also, out of 158 doctoral institutions, we're one of the top five colleges in the nation on sustainability, which is crucial at this moment in time. And our students are passionate about this. We're number one in campus engagement on sustainability. Another thing to consider is the value of an engineering degree. This is data from the class of 2019 from our Center for Career Development. As you can see, within 6 months of graduation, 92% of our students are either employed full-time or pursuing another degree. The mean salary is $72,000 with a BS in engineering. Our engineers are in demand and usually quickly employed both in the state and around the country and the world. But why choose UConn Engineering? Well, there are many reasons, and one of the best ones that I can think of right now is here. Engineers are problem solvers, and they're entrepreneurial. They see a problem, and they are very good about thinking about how to solve it with limited resources and within constraints. That's exactly what Professor Jeff McCutcheon and his team have done over the last several weeks, working collaboratively to build a prototype ventilator during this crisis. Engineering is about solving problems to ultimately make the world a better place, and UConn Engineering is a place where this is happening every day. So these are some of the topics that I'd like to cover with you today, and as I said before, please feel free to follow up with me or any of my colleagues after this for more information. We'll start with academic advising and registration. I'd like to introduce you now to the Director of Advising, Ms. Whitney LaSapio. Whitney has been with the School of Engineering since 2014 and director since 2017. And she leads a talented group of professional advisors who will help the freshmen and sophomores before they transition to a faculty advisor in their junior year. If you're watching this during the live session, Whitney is going to be one of our live Q&A panelists and can answer questions that you might have. So there are some changes for this year to orientation and summer registration. Both will be going online. Orientation services will be in touch with you about registering for a session. During orientation, you'll get to interact with our advising team, talk about AP or ACE credits that you might be bringing, and answer other academic questions. You'll learn how to register for your fall 2020 classes. The freshman curriculum is largely common in engineering, which allows you flexibility if you haven't yet decided on a specific field of engineering. You'll come out of the summer registration process with your full fall 2020 schedule. Moving forward, academic advising in the school is mandatory each semester, either with your professional or faculty advisor, to help keep you on track and get your questions answered. Next, I'd like to move on and talk about engineering at our regional campuses. We have four terrific regional campuses around the state: Avery Point, Hartford, Stamford, and Waterbury. It is possible to start the engineering program at any of the regional campuses. Students typically stay for 1 to 2 years, depending upon the campus and their particular field of study, before transitioning to STORS to complete their degree. For questions about the regional campuses, a great resource is Ms. Shoshana Armington, our Assistant Director of Advising for Student Transitions, who advises almost all of our students at the regional campuses. If you're watching during the live session, Shoshana is also one of our Q&A live panelists and can answer questions that you might have. We're also very excited about our recently launched four-year computer science program at the Stamford campus. With new faculty and a unique concentrations available at the Stamford campus that highlight its unique position in the state, we look forward to expanding and growing this program over the next several years. For more information, you can visit the CS website at both the STORS and Stamford campus websites. Next up, I'd like to talk about the opportunities for studying engineering abroad. While international travel is currently curtailed because of the COVID crisis, engineering is an internationally in-demand field, and the opportunities to study abroad are numerous. We currently have four dual degree programs that result in a student earning a BS or BSc in an engineering discipline and a second degree from liberal arts in a language specialty area. These programs are typically 5 years and involve spending a year abroad doing both academic and co-curricular work. We have the Eurotech program, which is a dual degree in engineering and German studies since 1993 and has over 100 students in the program currently. Our Engineering in Spanish program, or ESP, is a dual degree with engineering in Spanish, started in 2015 with over 40 students in the program currently. Our Asia Tech program, a dual degree with engineering in Chinese, started in 2017 with over 10 students. And our newest, Technopole France, a dual degree with engineering and French, started in 2018 with more than 30 students in it right now. In addition to these dedicated programs, there are numerous other opportunities to study engineering internationally, and we encourage students to talk with our education abroad team and their advisor at the university to explore options and make a plan. Next up, I'd like to talk about engineering internships and co-op experiences. About 80% of engineering graduates report participating in what we call experiential learning. This includes internships, research experiences for undergraduates, REUs, and cooperative education, or co-op. Since 2017, the School of Engineering has focused efforts on increasing the number of students pursuing cooperative education, or co-op, with employers in the state of Connecticut and beyond. Co-ops are currently a voluntary option for students, and about 10% of our students are participating in the program each year. We're working with key employers to increase this number and provide a variety of opportunities. The School of Engineering also participates in and hosts numerous career fairs each year with more than 100 companies to facilitate connecting students with these important learning opportunities. For more information about both of these experiential programs, education abroad and internship and co-ops, please feel free to contact Mr. Brian Schwartz, our Director of Experiential Engineering Education Initiatives. Next up, I'd like to talk about our opportunities in diversity and outreach. One of the most significant things we do is to think about how to communicate to the public what engineering is and what engineers do, and also to get current K-12 students excited about becoming engineers. One of the other most significant things we do is think about how to increase the number of traditionally underrepresented minorities in engineering. For both of these sets of activities, we have a terrific staff as well as student volunteers who run many programs to support this mission. There are so many programs that our team runs in support of this mission, and this is just a sampling of what we offer. I'll touch on two here, Bridge and EA. Bridge is a 5-week intensive summer program designed to prepare students who are underrepresented in engineering fields for the rigor of the engineering curriculum at UConn, introduce them to leadership opportunities, careers in engineering, and to familiarize them with the University of Connecticut and the college experience as a whole. Students also get to attend industry tours at some of the most prominent engineering companies in Connecticut, such as Pratt & Whitney, Unilever, Medtronic, Electric Boat, Sikorsky, Stanley, Ensign Bickford, Collins, and Otis, to name a few, to network with professionals and to learn about career opportunities that are available to them after graduation. Engineering Ambassadors, our largest organization, is a chapter that has been active for about 8 years and has reached over 25,000 students in Connecticut and the surrounding areas. They are dedicated to inspiring the next generation of engineers through on and off campus visits, conducting engineering tours for students during the school years at open house, women in engineering events, and hosting many other outreach events such as STEM Night at the Hartford Science Center, the Rube Goldberg Competition, and the Science Salon. One of our other goals over the last several years has been to continuously increase the number of young women engaged in engineering and to continue our journey towards gender parity in the School of Engineering here at UConn. Because of the programs we run and the dedication of our team, we've made significant progress here. We've doubled the number of female engineering graduates since 2012, and we've nearly tripled the number of young women studying engineering in the school in the past decade. There's still much more work to be done, though. For any questions that you might have about the diversity and outreach programs or opportunities, please contact either Kevin McLaughlin or Velda Alfred Abney in EDOC, our Engineering Diversity and Outreach Center. You can find out a lot more about what they do at their website, edoc.engr.ucon.edu. I'd like now to talk briefly about engineering scholarship opportunities. Each year, the School of Engineering awards more than 150 unique scholarships with a total value in the hundreds of thousands of dollars. These scholarships are both merit-based and need-based, and students can apply for them starting in their freshman year to be awarded in their sophomore year and beyond. We encourage all students to apply for these as they are typically in addition to other scholarships you receive through the university, subject to federal financial aid rules. I'd like to wrap up our time here today with a brief discussion of some of the unique programs and opportunities I think UConn offers. The first is our engineering and other learning communities, which provide students with a unique way to theme their residential experience around an interest area. The Engineering House Living Learning Community in Worth Tower focuses on professional development and experiential learning. We have 100 first years and 60 second year students in the learning community, plus 5 residence assistants and 5 floor mentors. Engineering House students participate in team-based learning throughout the first year curriculum, and students gain valuable skills that help them find internships during the summer. For the last several years, we've run a service learning project for students where students get to see the impact of engineering work on the community. An Engineering House is only one of several different learning communities that students are able to participate in. Almost all of our freshman engineering students participate in the ENGR 1166 Foundations of Engineering course, where they get to work in small teams on hands-on projects over the course of the spring semester of their freshman year. Students get to work in our new 2,000 square foot Freshman Cornerstone Laboratory in the United Technologies building, pictured here, and have access both to tools and the makerspace to translate their ideas and prototypes into reality. This is the beginning of their engineering design education, which will continue throughout their curriculum. That will culminate in their Capstone Senior Design Project, a year-long project under the guidance of a faculty mentor and, in many cases, an industrial sponsor. This gives our students the opportunity to do a deep dive on a real project and learn what it takes to be successful in engineering beyond just the technical. This year, we have more than 750 seniors and 228 senior design projects. The picture here is from the 2019 Senior Design Day held at Gamble Pavilion. Due to this year's pandemic, we aren't able to host an in-person event this year, but we are planning a virtual one, where all of our students will be able to have their work showcased to the public. More information about this event will be on our website as we get closer to May, and we invite all of you to visit the site when it's launched to see the amazing things that our students have worked on in the last academic year. Undergraduate research is a strong tradition in the School of Engineering. Many of our students are also in the honors program, and so use undergraduate research as a way to fulfill their thesis requirements. Outside of that, many students take independent study or independent research credits towards their degree requirements and work closely with faculty on cutting-edge research opportunities that contribute both to the fundamental knowledge base, but in many cases also to products and technologies that contribute to the economic growth and health of the Connecticut economy. We also have a number of programs that are unique to UConn, like our Navy STEM concentration, which prepares students to work in engineering fields that support the important work that Connecticut does in the naval sector. This program allows students to work on design projects and research projects that are connected to areas of interest to the Navy and to their supply chains, as well as interact with professionals and researchers working in these important fields. Another new program that we're very excited about is the new joint venture between the School of Fine Arts and the School of Engineering, the Kenickie Institute for Arts and Engineering. This new partnership will explore the intersection of the two fields with joint events and programs, new minors, and eventually joint majors. We're pleased to announce 2 new minors for the fall 2020 semester, one in theater and entertainment engineering and one in industrial design, both of which can be paired with any engineering degree. So that is a high-level overview of the School of Engineering and our many activities. In the coming days, all of our departments will be hosting their own virtual events where you can find out more about specific programs. All of the schedules and information will be on our website, www.engr.edu/UConnBound2020. Thank you for all attending today, and we look forward to you joining us in the fall 2020 semester.